This is World Autism Week, and many people are hoping it will be bigger and better than ever and do even more to help create a society that works with and for autistic people. Mott Walker spoke to composer, musician and volunteer trustee of the Autism Charity, ASSERT Brighton and Hove, to find out more.
So I'm joined here today by Anya Ustaszewski, and we're going to be marking Autism Awareness Week, which is, I think, 1st to the 7th of April.
That's
and you're
right.
Here to kind of tell your story about it, but also tell us a bit more about the condition. Is that right?
So, that's right, yeah, happy to do that.
Yeah, so, I mean, what is autism, really, for people that don't know much about it? What are the signs? What does it mean to be, if someone is autistic?
I would say, if I had to put it in a sentence, it's a very different way of perceiving and interacting with the world. The areas of difficulty that we mainly have are kind of the social communication side of things, so knowing what people are thinking and feeling, because we don't just say in pure words what we think and feel. We do things with our body, we do things with our tone of voice, and that's quite hard to read. In terms of us putting out communication, some autistic people are not able to speak, so they communicate with devices like tablets. Some people find it hard to articulate themselves, even if they do have speech. We can be misunderstood because we don't know how to, say, comfort people when they're upset.
Yeah.
It's not that we don't care. We don't know what social tool to deploy.
Yeah.
So people say we lack empathy. They say that we're insensitive. They say that we're self-centred, which is untrue and not really very fair. Another key thing is that we have sensory sensitivities. So sounds, sights that other people might not really notice can be really painful to us.
Yeah, and 1% of the population has this condition, but there's a lot of undiagnosed people, aren't there, with this condition? So
that's right, yeah. It's quite hard to diagnose. There's still not as much awareness out there as we'd like about how you might know that you're autistic.
Yeah.
Women in particular, we think, are underdiagnosed. Some women get diagnosed borderline personality disorder and then subsequently get re-diagnosed as being autistic. So there's interesting overlap there between those conditions that more research, I think, is needed there.
Yeah, but the thing is, I mean, because you've been diagnosed with autism, but I mean, you live a really good, everyday life, so you can live with this condition, can't you? And I know you're a trustee of a charity, aren't you, as well? And that kind of helps to ensure that people who are autistic can, get about their daily lives. Is that right?
That's right, yeah. I'm a trustee of the charity ASSERT Brighton and Hove, and we work with people mainly who don't have a learning disability, because there's a gap there, because people in that category don't always get social services support because we're not eligible. So ASSERT provide advocacy, benefits, advice. We also do a lot of life skills things, so like cookery, emotion management, using public transport. We do lots of activities as well for social inclusion. So we're looking at doing Go Ape, which I think will be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And we do things like pottery, painting, bowling, that kind of thing. And we also have drop-ins. We have events for parents, partners and carers of adult autistic people as well.
Yeah.
And we have a regular discussion group that we use to discuss different topics that we want to kind of air, but that are hard to put into non-autistic spaces.
Yeah, OK. And just lastly, so it's Autism Awareness Week next week, 1st to 7th of April. Is your organisation running any events or any information days? And where can people find out more information about the organisation?
We've just launched a new website in time for Autism Awareness Week.
Okay.
So people are welcome to go to that. That's assertbh.org.uk, just to check it out. It has everything about what we do, who we are. We just have general awareness all the time, so we always have leaflets available. You can request information from us. We offer training. We also work with an organisation called Ask, who have an app called the Autistic Space Kit that you can download, and it will speak for you if you're distressed. It will have your emergency contacts. So that's something that's good for safety as well as just for practical comfort.
Great. OK. Anya, really good to see you today. And all the best for the Awareness Week next week, and also your musical career as well.
Thank you. Lovely to talk to you.
Thanks.